failure will teach me something or the other, that maybe this wasn't meant to be for me, maybe I need to work harder, maybe my best is not good enough. And the more you're scared of failure, every time you cry and feel sad, the more you're scared of failure, chances are you'll stop failing as often as you did.
And I'm sure all of you have had your fair share of empty theater movie experiences. You step into the theater as purists, wondering that people have to be coming for such a unique movie offering, right? No. Me, you, and others are the small portion of the population that seek for new, complex, and innovative storytelling. While the majority in India equate the theater experience for escapism from all the worries in their personal life. And this is in no way to say one is more profound or better than the other. It's just a noticeable fact that entertainment trumps art in this nation. But sadly, this correlation leads to several extremely thought-provoking and powerful films showcasing to empty theaters, leading to miserable business in the box office and exorbitant losses. A combination of eccentric topics, lack of marketing, and sheer disinterest from the masses, taking a look at some of the films I believe deserved an audience in theaters, here is Tried&Refused Productions with 10 Bollywood financial disasters that deserved an audience in theaters. All the figures that are provided in this video are from Box Office India. A Death in the Ganj. One of the most interesting movie experiences for me was when I stepped in for the Konkana Sen directed film A Death in the Ganj in 2017. 2017 was the year which was dreadful financially for the Hindi film industry. While star-led films didn't work, even experiments like A Death in the Ganj financially failed. The film did a worldwide gross revenue of just over a crore. Based on a short story written by Mukul Sharma, Konkana Sen's father, the film is a delicious concoction that incorporates both humor as well as mystery, all set in 1979 in an old but charming town of Miklujki Ganj. The film has a phenomenal star cast, with riveting performances especially by Ranveer Shori and Vikrant Massey, and credible support by Gulshan Devaiya, Jim Sarb, Kalki, as well as Tilotma. How what is presumably a get-together meant for Mary unravels several mysteries about individuals and the relationship makes for a brilliantly designed film by Konkana Sen. The sense of weariness and unpredictability consistent throughout the film and its social messaging, if you dwell deeper, will make you fall in love with it. You can check out the film on Amazon Prime Video. Aligarh. One of the most gut-wrenchingly painful films even today after 4 years from Hindi cinema is the Hansal Mehta directed film Aligarh, starring Manoj Bajpayee and Rajkumar Rao in lead roles. The film, which is based on the true story of Ramchandra Saras, a Marathi professor in Aligarh Muslim University, who was suspended for having been caught having consensual sex with a man on grounds of morality. The mental toll that it took on the individual from an invasion of privacy, ridicule and disgust from society, and the complete lack of support from the university makes Aligarh an extremely tough film to watch. Even more so due to the powerful performance by Manoj Bajpayee that treats a character from the LGBTQ community as any other human, rather than the jarring caricatures we have been subjected to in Hindi cinema.
I never looked at Professor Siras as gay. I looked at him as a great Lata Mangeshkar admirer and, you know, great Marathi literature professor. So if you see the film, that's how I have designed him, you know. That is why I have never, you know, tried to make him look the stereotypical gay.
Rao, who lends beautiful support in the film, creates, honest to God, cinema gold from both the storytelling as well as performance standpoint. Hansal Mehta deserves all the praise. The film, made on a budget of close to 11 crores, did about 3.7 crores in its worldwide gross revenue and was deemed a financial disaster, but still lives on to be one of Bajpayee's most important performances that lives on beyond just a business model. Manto. Nandita Das is an extremely ambitious filmmaker, and even after Firaq and the convoluted and layered matters it focused on, she took on the challenge to tell the fascinating true story of Manto, an extremely famous, notorious for some, storyteller. Set in the 1940s near the independence of India from the British Raj, it follows the journey of Manto as a scriptwriter in the Bombay film industry, the religious anarchy that boils due to the partition, his consistent tussling with what the establishment found obscene and unacceptable, and his disintegration into drunkenness and isolation as well.
लोग जैसे मुझे कहते हैं, हाँ मंटो लग तो बड़ी कमाल रही है, हम देखने आएंगे. आम आदमी को समझ आएगी क्या? मैं कहा भैया आप कैसे जानते हो? आप आम आदमी को क्यों इतना छोटा समझते हो? और मंटो के जमाने में खुद आम आदमी ही कॉलम के लिए वेट करते थे.
The events in his real life being spilled out clearly, just like his short stories, a provocateur for some, a revolutionary for others in the case of freedom of expression, Nawazuddin Siddiqui showcases spectacular range as Manto, with great support from artists like Tahir Raj Bhasin and Rasika Duggal. The film merely did a worldwide gross revenue of 4.71 crores and was deemed a financial failure. But I assure you, you won't regret watching it on Netflix. Fun fact, Nawazuddin Siddiqui took 1 rupee as acting fees for this film. Mard ko dard nahi hota. One of the most enjoyable theatre experiences, independent from the fact that I was shamelessly resting my feet in the seat in front of me because it was an empty theatre, was the Vasan Bala directed film Mard ko dard nahi hota. A film that has the boundless potential of developing into a superhero franchise. And for us to take strides in a genre, we have only Krish to depend on. A primary character with congenital insensitivity to pain, a love story that blossomed from a young age, the development of a badass character like Supri, martial arts mentors like a one-legged karate Mani, and this mischievous and absolutely hilarious antagonist Jimmy. It had all the elements of a wacky yet so impactful superhero film, giving me flashbacks of films like Kick-Ass and The Scott Pilgrim vs. the World. While Abhimanyu and Radhika did a splendid job, Devaiya especially, as Jimmy steals the show.
I don't think we should ever hold the audience responsible for something. You know, it is their choice, right? I think we need to up our game to kind of see how we reach them rather than they reach us.
The film is what we need to develop our homegrown and original superheroes, exactly what the new upcoming Tuvino Thomas Malayalam film is attempting. Mard ko dard nahi hota on a budget of 17 crores did only 3.03 crores in worldwide gross revenue. But it is a step towards the right direction. Can we revive it in any way? Laila Majnu, a film with spectacular performances that I remember so vividly, was 2 years ago when I saw the Sajid Ali directed film Laila Majnu. Beyond being a classic storyline, which has been adapted several times, its contemporary adaptation in Kashmir took me by surprise. The enchanting chemistry between the two main leads that never seemed too sappy or over the top. The pain invoked, especially by Avinash Tiwari, of both helplessly falling in love and slowly becoming one with the world. It honestly fully mesmerized me.
फिल्म का नाम लैला मजनू ना होता और आप ये फिल्म को देखकर वापस बाहर आते तो एक आज की कहानी देखते और मैं आपको बताता कि ये जो कहानी आप देखकर आ रहे हैं ये लैला मजनू की कहानी है.
It still possesses one of the most underrated music albums in Hindi cinema, composed by Niladri Kumar and Joy Barua. While all are my favorites, including the title track and Half Is Half Is, I would highly recommend you check out the beautiful picturization in the song Tum Nazar Mein Raho on YouTube. The chemistry just through gestures and eye contact and the way Kashmir has been captured, especially in its festivities, is something unique to this film. Please give this a chance on Z5. The film did merely 2 crores of business in its theatrical run and it deserves so much more appreciation. Aankho Dekhi. An exceptionally deep and well-executed film was the Rajat Kapoor-directed film Aankho Dekhi that released in 2014. The film provides for a thought-provoking take on human perception, faith, pragmatism, and how everything encompassing these elements leads to shaping societies. Through the vessel of a joint family in Delhi, Rajat Kapoor brilliantly sheds light on how a man in his late 50s, a beautiful portrayal by Sanjay Mishra by the way, is deeply impacted to only believe what he himself notices. Ridiculed by many, praised for his vision of clarity, Aankho Dekhi provides for several poignant questions regarding observations and the mysterious nature with which humans function on a daily basis, marching on with no care in the world of the several mysteries we assume to be the gospel truth.
Naseer saab ne ek mail dala tha unko ki beta Rajat Kapoor, agar tune ye wala role Pankaj Kapoor ya Om Puri ya Paresh Rawal Anupam Kher se karwaya hota na to dobara tujhse main baat nahi karta, lekin tu Sanjay Mishra se karwa raha hai to shayad ye picture uske liye milestone hoga.
This film had a disastrous run in the box office, only collecting over a crore in its worldwide gross revenue. I assure you, this one is simply beautiful. Parched. Can you imagine the powerful and socially irrelevant film Parched did merely 1.98 crores of business in India, while it did close to 10 crores of business in the international market, also becoming one of the highest grossing Hindi films in France, Still deemed a financial failure, it sheds light on the contrast to cinema that connects with people on a global scale. Directed by Leena Yadav, the film follows the several social issues that the characters Rani, Lajjo, Bijli and Janki face in a village in Rajasthan. The sexist laws of the panchayat, women having no stake in their own fate, marital abuse, dowry, child marriage, all social evils that many parts of the country are still plagued by today.
Interesting thing, but also the heartbreaking thing of it, that the kind of misogyny and stuff that exists in this village still exists even in the most progressive societies.
Absolutely.
We've just learned to hide it better.
Absolutely.
So what progress has done is it's like just cleaned up the surface.
Parched beautifully weaves these elements in the arduous journeys of the female characters. It is a film that does not shy away to showcase the gory details. Sadly, the bitter truth for many. This impactful film is a necessary watch for both its importance and the powerful performances of the star cast. Masaan. Painful is an understatement whenever I revisit the Neeraj Gaivan directed and Varun Grover written film Masaan. Made on a budget of 8 crores, the film did an adjusted net revenue of 3.8 crores. While I understand that the film boasts of relatively new faces and limited marketing, which would have translated to decreasing footfalls in theatres, the relevance and timelessness of Masaan still standing the test of time today tells you how the masses don't really get excited about stories that provide a reflection to our society and its several problems. A breakout role for Vicky Kaushal, such earnestness by Shweta Tripathi, and especially maturity and believability by Richa Chadda and Sanjay Mishra. How can I forget the show stealer in every scene, Pankaj Tripathi? This gem of a film has a lingering sadness even in its slightly joyous moments. And so is life, I guess, for so many people like Deepak and Devi. A film that will be remembered for many years to come. Karwa. I will wholeheartedly support the debut of Dulquer Salman in Karwa as something the beauty of which went unnoticed by the masses. Both a combination of the media dismissing it as a simple road film and the masses simply not being interested in the product. Karwa could not even break even its 23 crore budget in its theatrical run. The film treats death as an inevitable reality, something that we have to come to terms with as humans. Yet in retrospect, also think about whether we take the life we are leading and the people that are closest to us for granted. That realization and arc shown through a road film involving three misfits, each performing with such natural rhythm, especially Irfan, that cross paths with one another, creates a beautiful storyline.
First of all, nobody here is waiting for me to come and make a splash. Okay, I'm not delusional. I love that it had Irfan and all those things that you said. But I always knew it's not a very commercial pitch.
Sure.
It was never mounted that way.
I will never forget the lines, "Kuch baatein sirf waqt ke baad hi samajh aati hain." Aur ab, jab samajh aa hi gaya hai, saath bitane ke liye waqt hi nahi hai. This film will forever have a special place in my heart. It's available on Amazon Prime Video. Lal Kaptan. One of the most heartbreaking fates that I saw of a film that was not only original, ambitious and path-breaking, but could have honestly developed into an Indian graphic novel so beautifully interspersed with Indian history as well as mythology was the 2019 film Lal Kaptan starring Saif Ali Khan. We criticize mainstream actors for not taking enough risks and when they do, we dismiss it as outlandish projects. Lal Kaptan with its 41 crore budget tanked miserably, only generating close to 2.7 crores in its adjusted net revenue. An unapologetic Western rooted in India as British imperialists wanted to ravage the country. At a time where the country was torn into several pieces or empires, but the East India Company through its various tactics finding ways to antagonize allies amongst each other. And in this world full of chaos, post the Battle of Buxar, we have a lone wolf, a bounty hunter, a man of few words and many actions, on the quest for his next target that has personal links with the mysterious man. This film was meant for the big screen, but as we can only talk about the present, its storytelling and cinematic execution is something that will be remembered. I am extremely sure about that, of a risk by an actor that wasn't scared. But maybe, just maybe, we'll never take that plunge again.
I don't know, I think I'm really lucky that one continues to work and to be offered interesting stuff, despite a debacle like that. But would I do it again? Perhaps not.
And that was the video, guys. Write it down in the comments below whether you have some video ideas for our channel. Please don't forget to follow me on Instagram. The handle's right in front of you. Follow me at JammyPants4. Also, please support us by smashing the like button and subscribing to our channel for weekly content ahead. Thank you for watching.